So, I wasn't exactly feeling my orange oak cabinets. They are wood, but the oranginess just wasn't doing it for me. Since I had already painted some other cabinets in the bathroom, I brought it downstairs to see if maybe I could expand the white into the kitchen, but it was a little too white for me. And somehow I stumbled upon this Beyond Paint on like the Home Shopping Network or something, and I read a couple of reviews, watched a couple of YouTube videos, and I was sold.
I just opened my paint. It's called Ash Soft Gray. And I wanted to see, what the color looked like. And I'm pleasantly surprised. It's a soft gray. It's not as dark as the counter you see, and it's not as white as that removable wallpaper. So really loving it so far. I put up a little bit on here. I'm getting back up a little bit so you can see it. But I really think this is what I was looking for. I ain't finna do no painting today because I got all my new Lululemons. But, babe, is you ready?
So I filmed that video when I first did it. I sent it to my sister. But here is a list of the supplies that I used in transforming my kitchen. I'm going to link below the blog that gave me the inspiration as well as the courage to take on this big task. The first thing that I did was I removed all the cabinets. So my cabinets are about 30 years old. And some of the doors need a bit more attention, so there was some spackling and sanding involved. I used little Dixie cups to prop the doors up so I could paint the top as well as the sides at the same time. And I used two folding tables in front of the TV. I did this in January of 2021, so I had plenty of space to take my time and paint and chill.
Girl, this paint dried down so nice. I've been doing real thin coats. You see, this is actually two coats, but it's still kind of sheer. But I'll do one more. I've been doing three for the outside of the cabinets, but it dries down so nice. Okay, that's it. The only thing is, it has to sit for 30 days to do what it says. It's basically called cure, to cure, like so that it sticks to the cabinet. So once I get them all painted, I gotta wait 30 days from that day to put them back up. I could put them up sooner, but I'm not going to because I want them to really stick. But all right, that's my weekend update.
Something else I did was I labeled them all so that they could all go back to their same place. I actually did a lot of this at night because then, there's less hands and then you don't have to worry about anybody bumping into your paint. But this paint does dry down pretty quickly and there's no smell. Once all the cabinets were painted, I did wait 30 days before I put them back up to let them cure. Once I start putting them back up, I was loving it. So if you notice, I did end up buying knobs and pulls to add on the kitchen cabinet doors once it was completed to give it that, finished look. And there's a tool you can buy to make sure that you get the placement in the same spot on all the cabinets. That's important to help it look polished. So now come the images of wear and tear over the last 12 to 15 months. You can see, these are the handles that we use almost every day. Sometimes you'll see where it's friction, where the drawer comes into contact with something, so it scratches the paint off. And what happens is I just let it pile up until I get tired of looking at it, and then I bring out the paint and do touch-ups. So when it's time for touch-ups, typically what I will do is I will just take out the paint and a small paintbrush. I will wipe down all the cabinets and then I just touch up the paint with the smallest brush, you know, that's needed for the job. It really doesn't take long. I've had to do 2 touch-ups over the last 12 to 15 months. So for me, that's, I guess, twice a year. It's a no-brainer. I still highly recommend. You can see, you know, the paint looks a little lighter when it's wet, but then it dries down and blends in just fine. If I could have done anything differently, I probably would have primed them, maybe with some spray primer before painting them. But for the amount of time that I put into this and effort, I absolutely love the result so much more than the oaky cabinets. And to only have to touch it up twice a year and the touch-ups take maybe 15 minutes and you know, it's dry, I have no regrets. So will you see brush strokes? Probably. Will you get little dings? Probably. Will your kitchen look nice until you can get your forever kitchen? Absolutely. If you're seeking something that's more permanent and long-term, I definitely recommend speaking to a professional. But if you just need something to hold you over and help your kitchen look nicer until you can do a full makeover, I definitely recommend painting your cabinets with Beyond Paint. They did not pay me to say that.